Hey, I'm Ben. I guess you can tell today's pretty hot. Man, am I glad I'm in the shade. Nick and Bob have to practice for another hour. Then we're going to a movie. Nick's having a hard time adjusting to the temperature. Did you know too much heat can really make you sick? I think that's what's happening to Nick. Heat illness, I think they call it. Man, he's not looking so good right now. Our coach tries to schedule practice during the coolest hours of the day, but here in Arizona, it never really gets that cool. He says it could take up to 2 weeks to get used to the heat. He's always telling Nick to drink water and take breaks in the shade, but Nick will only drink soda, and he pushes himself too hard at practice. It's important to know the signs of heat illness for yourself and other people. The signs are thirst, weakness, cramps, headache, sweating more than normal, throwing up, or even passing out. I'm glad the coach is here to help. If you have a friend who seems to be sick from the sun, remember to take them to the nearest shade, take off any extra clothes and sports padding, tell the person to lie down and raise up their feet, put cool cloths on the person or mist with water, and give them water to drink. If a person doesn't stop vomiting or is really sick even after all this, call 911 right away. It helps to remember to drink 8 gulps of water every 15 minutes. Nick seems to be doing much better thanks to the quick response by the coach. But since Nick got so sick, he can't finish practice. The coach is having him go inside to where it's cooler. Since Bob listened to coach's advice, he's going to step in and take Nick's place for the rest of practice. This reminds me of another close call. Heat can make anyone sick. I know, because it almost happened to my little brother. It wasn't that long ago. My mom came to school to drop off some homework. She got out of the car and got a phone call. I guess it was really important because she ran inside the school and forgot my brother was in the back seat. Someone heard him crying and called the principal. It was scary. Luckily, my mom was right there and was able to get my brother. Boy, was he happy to see her. Remember, vehicles heat up very quickly in our Arizona sun. In just several minutes, the inside of a car can overheat a small child or pet. Whenever you are outside, the first thing you should remember to do is to hydrate. Drink 8 gulps of water every 15 minutes, especially before and during activities in hot and sunny weather. Carry water with you at all times when the weather is hot. Stay away from drinks that have caffeine, lots of sugar, or carbonation like sodas and tea. Wear light-colored, loose-fitting clothes and a shady, wide-brimmed hat. Limit the time you spend playing outside during the hot parts of the day. If you feel thirsty or hot, go indoors into the air conditioning. If you start to feel sick, get help. Tell an adult like your teacher or parent. I guess you can see now why it's really important to be careful when you're out in hot weather. Remember to pay attention to your body when you start to get hot. Follow steps for treatment when someone gets sick and find an adult. Make sure everyone, especially children and pets, get out of the car. And don't forget, be heat-wise and sun-wise. Stay hydrated, wear sunscreen, and play in the shade so you can enjoy the outdoors without getting sick. Hey, now that I think of it, I'm getting pretty hot out here. I think I'll head inside and find out how Nick is doing.